known as the lease transaction. So you ask yourself, from what we covered previously, Katwa Imiridotia, do you have some change? Okay. Do you have some change or something is still, we still have parts to prove? Okay. Yes. Okay. So let's get started. Okay. Let's get started with the lease transaction. With the lease transaction. So when you are dealing with a lease transaction, the first thing you need to appreciate that it behaves exactly like other transactions, okay? It behaves exactly like other transactions. It is divided into different stages. The three stages we looked at are still the same stages in this transaction. What you should note, we can also sell a lease, okay? So, but basically what we are looking at this time around, how do we lease land? So when you are entering into this transaction, make sure at least you know the implication of your transaction, okay? So let's settle, okay? I just summarize, okay? Okay. Yesterday, or even in our first sessions, okay, we came to realize that we have what we call general restrictions to land transactions. All the transactions we've been looking at, they are restricted in one way or the other. So, but however, every transaction has its particular restrictions. So before you enter into a lease transaction, okay, it has what we call legal restrictions. So you ask yourself, what factors, okay, may ban me from entering into a lease transaction, okay? Because you have an obligation to enter into a transaction that you really understand and appreciate, not partially, but wholly. Why? Regulation 12 of the Advocates Professional Conduct Regulations requires you as an advocate to diligently advise your client. So at this point, we are at that stage, okay, of before the transaction, okay? Before the transaction. So that being the case, you need to appreciate that before I enter into a lease transaction, what things do I need to first understand, okay? Yesterday, we were able and lucky to have looked at what we call due diligence in general, not so? But now, when you are entering into a lease transaction, what type of due diligence do you need? Okay? When you look at section 101 of the RTA, it is very clear, okay? It says that the proprietor of any The proprietor of any, so you have the answer, you wrote it yesterday. The proprietor of any freehold or mile. So that means the first legal restriction in lease that the land should be mile or freehold. If it is not freehold, if it is not mine, find means of making it. Okay? Find means of making it either mine or free or freehold. Go wherever you can make it mine. Okay? You get it? So what does that mean? You enter Oros, they tell you, Rashid inherited land from his late father. Okay? We have one of the biggest investors in Uganda, Othieno, who is ready to construct a multi-billion hotel on this land. But it has come to your knowledge that Mr. Othieno wants a mere lease. Proceed. Okay? Proceed. Okay? We stop there. A lease can't be created on customary, so you have to convert it from customary to freehold. That's the first thing. Then they can tell you that Aisha inherited land from her late grandfather. Okay. However, Hajat Afua, as one of the most celebrated coffee growers in Chiriando, is interested in using this land for a period not exceeding 3 years. Okay? Ask yourself, do you have a lease below not exceeding 3 years? Which type of lease is that? Okay? Is it a license? Is it a lease? So you start thinking between lines. Okay, if not, they'll give you facts where the lease is there, but it is beyond 99 years, so it is upon you. Okay, then another requirement in due diligence. Yesterday, we discussed that, and you talked about that they may give you any title because remember, it is for free. And a freehold certificate is subject to conditions, not so. So they will give you a freehold certificate when it has a condition. When you open on the conditional page, because where you are used to only the lease title, they tell you your client wants a lease on that land. He intends to do this. Okay? He intends to do a lease on that. On that land, okay? But you know very well that under such circumstances, you should be able to note that that conditional freehold, the condition will always be a user clause. So you look at the freehold certificate, look at the conditional page. What do they need there? What is there, okay? So can your client take on a lease where the freehold title it is emanating from has a condition of only commercial, yet your client wants agriculture? Okay? You are still making due diligence. Because yes, it emanates from freehold, okay, and mile. Yes, we have given you a freehold certificate of title, but it has a condition that this land is only and only for commercial, but is your client intending to get a lease on commercial or farming? So you think between lines. Okay? So now we presume that because those are the restrictions, okay? But other restrictions we looked at are nationality. Okay? In that where a person intends to get a lease when he or she is a citizen of Uganda, it starts from how many years? Okay, a citizen can get a lease of 3 years, but a non-citizen starts from 5. Because a lease of 5 years and above should be registered. And that means under such circumstances, that lease of 5 years is for a non-citizen. You see these things happen in villages. Someone comes in and narizina ke wam chara chairman. Okay. It is 1 year yajitalis, which is a light thing. Okay, which they can't depreciate. Some of you have those transactions. You've done them. Okay. The way Aisha looks, she has written those contracts deep down there in Masaka. Okay. No. Okay. Okay. So now we presume that yes, when it is above 99 years, it don't take place. Okay, you advise them to lower their cases like 99. Okay. Yes. So now we presume that everything is okay. So now you want to enter into what we call in this transaction. We want to lease land. So how do we lease land? Concerning how do we lease land? By way of a contract. This contract is known as a lease agreement. We've always said that a lease, the law of contract is central in all transactional cost units. So this being a contract, it is in form of an agreement. So ask yourself, if we tell you that council drafts a lease agreement, as I've said, because you're going to proceed and draft it off head. Yes. So without a very concerned, Anita, she answered the first question.
I didn't pass it to Jeff.
We need the heading, the public of the land, the law, which is the contract, and then we need the specifications of the land, where the land is located. We indicate it's a freehold, a mile, wherever the land is located, the various law. Then we go to the body. Now, here in the body, no, before the body, we describe the parties, the seller, the lessee, the lessor. So after we've described the parties, we now go to the recitals. The recitals, after the recitals, we go to the conditions of the lease, the premium, the consideration, and then we make a conclusion.
So when you are dealing with an agreement, okay, an agreement, the biggest challenge you people have, I saw a variation deed, what you drafted this week, okay? What were the, how many pages, Cancer, did you have in your variation deed? 3 pages. Okay? No, this week, this very week. Okay? Okay? So, what I'm trying to explain that you people have a challenge. You see these documents in orals, you don't have anywhere you're going to look, okay? Where are you going to be looking? In your head, okay? So you should be having the art of drafting. Whether you know, but that art makes life very simple. Yesterday we drafted a sales agreement here. Well, it is very simple, but you have an agreement of 6 pages. You ask yourself, if an exam comes, when I'm to draft a sale agreement, can you copy the argument in your book and it fits in an exam? If it has 6 pages, okay, how many pages the booklets have? Now you get it. That's how you tell that whatever I have is in my book has a problem. So now, when you look at Article 137, says land belongs to the citizens of Uganda, who shall hold it in accordance with the following tenure systems. So when you look at by the fact that the tenure system you're going to deal with emanates from the constitution, okay, So that means the document you're going to draft is a public document. That's why it has the Republic of Uganda. Okay? Then we've said that in the law of transactions, the law of contract is central. Okay? And what are we dealing with? Land, not so. So you say, in the matter of the land act, the land we are dealing with, is it registered land or not? You say, in the matter of the registration of titles act, because this is going to be just an agreement between parties, we need the contracts. You say, and in the matter of the contracts act. So what are you going to draft? What are you going to draft? Then you indicate lease agreement. Okay? You indicate lease agreement. This lease agreement. Okay? Remember when you look at section 10 of the Contracts Act, okay? It is very clear that a contract is an agreement entered into between two or more parties with the free will, okay? With an intention to be legally bound, okay? So that means we need the parties. So you put between so and so herein after referred to as, which expression, if the context so admits, shall include successors, assignees in title. Then and you put the second party. Okay. Then because section 10 of the Contracts Act says, free will. We want to see that free will. Where do we get the free will from? Recitals. Whereas the first party is the registered proprietor of land comprised herein under and is desirous of entering into or leasing part of this land. You are bringing out the element of section 10, free will. Whereas the first party is the lawful and registered proprietor. Why? A lease is entered on registered. That's why I'm using the registered proprietor. Okay. Then you also describe the second party as well. Then after describing the parties, what are you dealing with? Yes? Recitals means, with these words we say, whereas, those are called recitals. Exactly. Okay. So now, okay. So what are we dealing with? Then the next step will be, you indicate that it is a lease. So now, when after getting that, you've shown us the intention. Unlike a sale agreement, here I will say this agreement is witnessed as here and there. So you start showing us what you guys have agreed upon. So now ask yourself, what are the contents of, what are the key features in a lease? That's where we are. Okay? Aisha, what are the key features in a lease? Okola mchalism za week. What are the key features on the list? Okay. No young. What are the key user clothes? You're too busy already. Okay. So the first one is description of land. Okay. Are you leasing the entire piece of land or you are leasing part of your land? That's what we want to see first, okay? Are you leasing part of the land or the entire? Then I had a second one. Duration, okay? Or more for how long, okay? 1 week as per Aisha's agreements, or, okay? Then after that, consideration. But the consideration in the lease is divided into? Into two. Divided into two. One is, yes. One, consideration in a lease is divided into?
Premium.
What is a premium? Council is saying premium is ground rent.
No, take the other thing.
Hey. What's that premium?
Premium is the actual amount that they have agreed to.
The actual amount they have agreed. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we need the answers. Hey, go sit down with money. Because what's that? Umma, you don't get an answer. Sit down. Okay, so it is divided into two, premium and rent. So ask yourself, when it comes to premium, what if they ask you, what is premium? Okay, that first deposit, that lump sum we have agreed upon, you give it to me at once. Okay. Then rent, that, you know, rent is given by the instance of rent to recognize your landlord. That's the essence of rent, to recognize the existence of your landlord. Okay, that's why rent is minimal. Kabakatono. Okay, so now, after the consideration, what else?
What about?
Okay, you can set rent is paid monthly, quarterly, annually, depending on how you guys have agreed. Okay. You've talked about, we described, you have the description. It is also there. Then you have what we call warrants. These are what we call implied terms and conditions. When you look at, when it comes to leases, we have those implied terms and conditions. It is an implied term that the lessor shall keep that leased property in tenable stage. Okay. It is an implied term that at all times the lessee shall. Okay. Who is the lessor and who is the lessee?
The lessor is the one leasing, the one who has interest
in
leasing the land to the
lessee. Who is the lessee?
The lessee is the one who is leasing.
Okay, so it is an implied term that the lessor shall at all times have a right, what is referred to as a reversionary interest, to enter and examine the leased premises within reasonable time and subject to notice. That is key. Within reasonable time and subject to notice. People have their problems. Your landlord, you want to see the sockets work, so you come at midnight. Okay? To see whether the sockets work. Because, you know, this tenant is not around, so the maid is there. Okay? So you want to check whether the sockets work. Okay? That isn't reasonable. Then it is an implied term that the lessee shall that the lessee shall enjoy exclusive possession. Why? Okay, that's what we call performance. Okay, the lessor performs by giving quiet enjoyment and vacant possession. Okay. Then the lessee performs by paying, okay, the consideration as we have agreed, okay? Councillor Savio, that is it. Was that the big head? Okay. So I will get it. Okay. Mm-hmm. So when it comes to those terms and conditions, okay, what happens where those terms and conditions have been breached? Okay. So that means you have to include a clause on settlement, what we call dispute, because things happen. Sentence rent yavulam amakanso rent tabulangako rent yavulam those who sleep in actual quarters rent tabul zabachori boka. Okay, so now, then lastly, when you are concluding your argument, it should be dated and signed. Okay. Oh, yeah. We should also include the term variation. Now, I want to change. Okay. Did you get the user clause? We didn't talk about the user clause. Hey, wasn't it the first? Yeah. Okay. So we should also include the user clause. Okay. Anyway, you put it before you date and sign. Now the challenge is you people think it should be consideration, what they want. Do you have everything that is required? Okay. You do, can reach there and when the devil is dancing on your head like this. Okay. So you get it. So now we have this agreement. An agreement is binding to the parties that are on. So what remedies are available in circumstances where the lessee is in breach? Okay. And what amounts to breach? Okay. What amounts to breach? Councillor Zawedi. What amounts to breach? Cancer said that when you contradict the user clause, okay? Cancer Mong Arafat, okay? Unmute. What amounts to?
Yes, good evening.
Uh-huh. Yes, Cancer.
A breach happens where a term to an argument or a condition to an argument has where the one of the parties to the agreement acts contrary to one of the terms or conditions.
Okay, so when worry. Thank you, Councillor. When it comes to the law of contract, we have two things. We have what we call a condition, and what is the effect of breaching a condition, and what is the effect of breaching a warrant?
When you breach a condition,
yes,
breach of a condition goes to the root of the contract, like the cracks of the contract. So, where a condition has been breached, and a condition goes to the root of the contract. So the contract can be, is it repudiated? One of the parties, but where one breaches a warranty, they can be, the affected party can be compensated through damages. So a warrant does not go to the root of the contract.
Whereas so the warrant does not go to the root of the contract. So first ask yourself, what are those pertinent conditions in a lease agreement that once we are in breach of this, you don't survive. So the first one,
a user
payment clause. Of rent. Tell you why you're carrying a tagger at the same day. Why would you know money? Me have a colleague who was giving a certain petrol station 100 by 100 in Imbare town. But the day that investor didn't come, the guy fell asleep. Hey, he joked with money. Okay? So then another one. When you violate the user clause. Okay? When you violate the user clause. Now, when it comes to a user clause, the law is a bit funny, okay? You know what happens? They'll give you a lease agreement, okay, in orals. Remember, a lease agreement, sometimes what they do, they first do what we call sample lease of 5 years. They put a condition in the 5 years that you should have developed, okay, a four-story building, okay? If you do that, the lease will automatically extend to the term of 49 years. They give you the title together with that lease agreement. They tell you, he's still constructing his first floor. Okay. You look at the title shows this guy is the registered proprietor and the certificate is out. But he's still constructing. So first ask yourself, okay, was the construction of this building in the 5 term, was it a condition or? Was it a condition or? So failure to fulfill that condition, does the lease survive or it does not survive? Yes? Does it survive? Hajat, does the lease survive?
It does.
Yes? Well, when you've not constructed the way they agreed, because when you look at that clause, they always use the word shall or should. Okay. Okay. So you ask yourself, is that a breach or it is not? Good. Okay. So what you should note, don't take this ordinary view in oros. Whatever you see, think between lines. Once you see the 5 years, just know the initial 5 years are always subject to a condition for fulfillment. Okay? There is something that is going around social media. Waria to waria. Okay? Yes? You vary for justifiable. You first vary that per clause. Okay? But everything is covered under variation. Okay? So now, we've seen the two major conditions. Let's give an example. What if you enter one of your houses? Let's assume she's a landlord. Eh? Take the blessings this year. You should be a landlord. Okay? We are fasting at Evidia. Here near LDC. You should buy that church. Okay? Inshallah. So let's assume you enter one of your apartments and the tenant, okay, who is one of your good paying tenants? Asas Brangolu, Rusa Kuranga Vidimumunda, Aunt Jolie Manazirete, or your Inomusuka. So you enter for inspection, you find when a kid wrote on the wall, "I love you, daddy," with charcoal. Okay? Remember, this tenant has the duty to keep the property in tenable state. Okay? Toyagala, ya densidi jewatia kisengi. Can that terminate someone's tenancy? It is a warrant. But if she's your tenant, Amazon is age. I've said if. There is a question. Aisha Mzungu. Okay. Oli Aisha Mzungu. You get it, okay? So if your tenant has spent 3 months without paying rent, okay, why non-payment of rent? You see the feeling you get to a tenant who does not pay rent, one that is very different from a tenant who pays rent in time. So when it comes to that, just all a chigumikiriza. Okay? So payment of rent is a condition. Because we are using examples in our daily life. Let's assume she's a strict landlord. Okay? She says, my houses are basically for. They are not commercial. So Aisha comes from the village. She sold her land. She rents on this apartment. Okay? Because in the village, they tell them when you go to Kampala, use each and every opportunity you see around. So she goes in the village, she collects matoke, nateka kulubala zanga, guzaba pang sabo. Abaka fude kachi, kachali. Okay? Na kira no kere nakawa na reti nyanya no utungula wakuweko. Bomusangao. How can you react? Wanoise uwa jajao. Okay? Wanoita unakawa. You get it. Why? It is basically residential, not commercial. Amaluga wagaze mchara. You see? So that is a condition. So where there is a breach of a condition, those are things you can't really withhold. So as a result of that, the ultimate remedy will be terminating of a lease. So that takes us to modes of termination. Okay. Yes, remedies are modes of termination of counsel. Because you're going to look at forfeiture. Isn't it a remedy? Isn't it a mode of termination? Just cover a zoom. Okay. So are we together? Termination and remedies, they are the same. Okay. So how do we terminate a lease? Okay. Cancel. Let's assume, before we go to those, whenever you go in orals and they give you a document, just know your answer is in that. No, don't panic. They'll give you a lease agreement which has a clause of no subleasing. And you find someone sub. Because you didn't read the agreement, you can't tell whether they are. Now, same applies to the mortgage deed you value poor. First, look for the right of taking before you start subducting, because there are those things that are very, very pertinent, but we don't put much emphasis on them. Okay, put that into consideration. Okay, so let's look at modes of termination. Cancel, I want two. One. Short call. So she has said that the first one is influx of time. Because remember, now, influx of time or expiration of time. You see that mode of termination. They tell you, your client wants to buy. Okay? Remember that I told you yesterday? First look at time. You calculate. If you have a small head like mine, which doesn't know mathematics, okay? Look at it and say, if the lease was granted in 1996 for 30 years, from 1996, how many years remaining to make 30? I think there are seven. Okay? You say seven and two. You get it. So before you tell your client to buy, what if your client buys a lease which is remaining one day? Setakaribedeko only one day. Yeyagaremu only one day like this. So when you get the leasehold title, first look at time. Because you can't once, because these guys are very wise, I'm telling you. Either they'll give you a title. Okay, where the lease has expired. Remember, the law is once the lease is terminated by influx of time, okay, it goes back to the owner. So they will tell you, counsel, have you read very well? He said, yes, kindly proceed and advise your client. The lease has expired. You can, God may help you identify that it has, but now you get that, okay. Where should my client apply? That's what they will be looking for, because your title will always have a lessor and a lessee. So once the lease has expired by influx, okay, it has been inflected, time has expired, the lease went back to the lessor. So what does that mean? You are going to enter into a new lease agreement with the lessor. So you are not buying the lease interest. Why? This person no longer has interest in land, because influx of time is a mode of termination. So that means the lease you want to buy no longer exists. It was terminated by influx of time. Okay? Yes? Okay. The lessee acquires a legal interest where it is registered. Please, okay, but again, it remains, it has to. Why the other title will not cease to happen? That's the challenge with this. Both titles will be okay. Yes, Kans.
Yes.
Kans, we've not yet reached attendances. We are still looking at leases. Okay, sir? What are they extending? Because remember, the lease no longer exists, cancel. You have to buy to enter into a fresh lease. You start afresh. You don't extend what is not there. Okay? Are we together? So now, if not influx of time, we have what we call surrender. Okay? We have what we call surrender. Counselor Daniel, kindly unmute. What do you understand by surrender? Counselor Daniel, what do you understand by surrender?
Yes, Counselor.
Kindly educate us on surrender as a mode of termination.
Thank you.
Council, you are perfectly not heard.
Okay. Are you hearing me?
Let Hajat take over, Council. Why you understand by surrender?
Okay, surrender. It's whereby the lessee is no longer interested in land, and then she agrees or he agrees to take back the interest in land to the lessee.
Okay, surrender. Okay, I hear some people saying that they surrender all their sins to who? You've done it all. You've done it all. Gana mukama nyonye. Mkozechi? Maliza kali. Okay? You get it? I have done it all. So you have, I've surrendered myself to you, Lord. Clean me. Okay? So, same applies here in leases. You know, brokers are very funny. Basolo kugamba. Awakola nusu unusu. So, no zimbabu kwese. No ulirango kumye. Na utamati obuze kulina na some universities. Like Chambogo. We have students had to sleep for 2K. Okay? So, you enter into this, okay? You inject a lot of money in this project. And at the end of the day, you are yielding nothing. So you say, you change these hostels into some other business, but it also refuses to work. Okay? You come to the conclusion that this place is not viable for business. So what you say, let me return it back to there. So you surrender your lease interest back to the lessor peacefully. But this is done by way of a surrender deed. Okay. Yes? Before. Okay? Before the lease expires, you surrender by way of a surrender deed. Okay? Then, after that, we have what we call forfeiture. Forfeiture. Okay? Inna lillahi wa inna lillahi raji'un. Isawallah msasire. We are msoba kwa mwejjana. You know that gentleman? No, nifefe. Go ahead, tafefeka. LC5 Kayunga District. Sadi ya kaila kumachia. Gaye tuze. Okay. So we have what we call forfeiture. Now, forfeiture is taking back what belongs to you. Okay. We have what we call simple businesses. We have people give people to, you may say, no kela kumachana ugula yo kupichi wakumu. No buwa, babufu kawa, no wajefu, wani. Okay? Babufuge. But these guys are not remitting money. So it is not serving the essence of you buying these border borders and your cars for Uber. So what you do in Amsterdam, kumatia, kubida wano babu parking. That's what, so you take what belongs to you back. So now here, the lessor, because of a fundamental breach of not paying rent, okay, we shall do forfeiture. Okay? Intivuzuba zikulemye? Zizecha. Okay? The lessor calls back the lease on grounds of non-payment or not being in possession. Sadi ali akuzimbi de kenyu nanga yajizimbe to yagala yo. Yatoyagala yo. There is a guy I saw. yali esiba kawala kato kachaine ebyokola msajja mkulu n'akazimbira enju ekagano gendayo. So he paid tuition, but the girl wasn't interested at all. So narakana pane sente zange zinalinga nkuwa. You saw that Mzee who filed a suit for breach of promise to marry. You read that case, but fortunately he won. But we have an appeal running. Anytime now, the boy child is going to be saved from problems. Because the current case, okay, solves all our problems. You eat transport money, we have a remedy now. So, sit down. Don't eat transport money. When they send you money for Nika, go. Okay? So now, when you look at forfeiture happens in two circumstances. One, non-payment of rent and failure to take possession. Once you don't take possession, this implies that you don't need the land. I gave you vacant possession, so you're taking me for granted. Okay? But you've seen some investors. They give them land, but they don't back. Wow, there is black who? Same money. Okay? So, after forfeiture, we said forfeiture happens in two ways. Failure to parent, and then failure to take possession. Okay? How do we do forfeiture? How do we do forfeiture? Aisha, how do we do forfeiture? Aisha Mzoom, it is sometimes known as re-entry. Okay? You re-enter your property. Okay? You re-enter. Okay? Re-entry. Okay? So now, if it is not forfeiture, it can be not yet. We have merger. Okay? We have merger. Councillor Zawedi, what do we merge? What do we merge? Yes? What do we merge? First, what interest, okay, does the lessee have in this land? The lessee has an equitable interest called known as the lease interest. Then the lessor has what we call a reversionary interest. So as a result of that, where any of the parties, these guys may come to consensus in Germany Hajat. Haji huyo possessor wa kuo msala. Okay. So the lessor has what we call a reversionary interest, and the lessee has what you call the equitable lease interest. So here you guys add, okay? The lessor brings his reversionary interest to the lessee, and then natural. So by virtue of that, the lease no longer exists. Lease agreement never out title never canceling and dio original title. Okay. So are we together? Yes. That isn't clear. Where the lesser gets his reversionary interest and
So then the lease is in there.
Okay.
That is that becomes the landlord.
So it's like this. The lessor has a reversionary interest. Okay, yes. Then the lessee has what we call the lease equitable interest. So under such circumstances, the lessor, okay, comes and tells the lessee, Zizachi, Evian. So they add. Once they add, the lease interest can't supersede the reversionary rate. So the lease interest literally disappears within. Okay, it is consumed by the reversionary interest. So Okay. So you propose to take over the lease before the lease expires. Okay. The lessor. So are we together now? Okay. So now, yes.
Tenure, like if I have a lease of 20 years and I was at least.
Now, once you do a merger, okay, the sublease is subject to that interest. Okay, once you do a merger, even the sublease ceases. Because you see how they ask in orals, eh? They'll give you facts where my lease is of 5 years. They give you the title. You see, I'm remaining with 2 years, not so. So what happens? They tell me, Hadjat wants, I want to sublease Hadjat for 3 years. So the question is, can I exceed my term? So when you are subleasing, you are within the 20. You get it? So that means if you are subleasing, the sublease should also stop when your term stops. So literally, a subleasee should follow exactly the same conditions the lessee has from the lessor. That is it. Even the user clause, the implied terms and conditions, everything, you don't deviate from the same. Okay. Yes, counsel? Okay. It depends. If it is agreed upon, well and good. Depends on the agreement. Okay? So now, what other remedies are available? Yes? We have what we call termination by notice. Okay? Termination by notice. So, under this type of termination, you issue me with a notice so that netterism, okay? That's why you guys have a prior notice that you have orals soon. Everyone knows that they're coming, okay? So chances are high. Next week, you are receiving the panels. Yes, you are receiving the panels. You see your name with the panel where you are appearing. Ogumerumu. Okay? Hey. Naija this week. So week yo. I take on Thursday. Yes, Friday is Good Friday. So again. Okay. Okay. I that Tanika Tuesday ka katia pate ke me okay the IA is on Thursday. Yes, that the term will have closed. That is your week for relaxation. The other week on Monday, okay? So Let's listen, okay? So the last one is termination by notice. So under here, you have to issue me with a sufficient notice that, Rashid, I'm intending to take over that land. Kindly sum up your projects. And okay, by notice, you serve me with a notice so that I get prepared. Okay, that anytime now I am taking over so that you get prepared. Okay, yes, okay. So now you see, whatever we've looked at, those are remedies of who? So. Yes? Yes. Balesa. Does death terminate a lease?
Yes.
Eh? Cancel. Did you read the recitals? Okay. Did you read the recitals? As the context so admits shall include successors in underlying successors. Does death terminate a lease? Thank you. Okay. Hey, now ask yourself, the lisi, yeah, inayoka ka remedy. Which remedies are available? It is called relief against forfeiture. Okay, it's one. Okay, the lisi has one remedy, which is known as relief against forfeiture. Yes. Aisha Black, what are the grounds upon which forfeiture can be granted? Okay. On what grounds can court grant forfeiture?
Forfeiture, when there is sick, is willing to pay.
So listen to my question. On what grounds does court grant forfeiture?
Non-payment.
So the ground is non-payment. Okay. So if it is non-payment, Brigadier Kwatampola, kindly unmute. You tell the circumstances under which court may grant a remedy of relief against forfeiture.
It's a circumstance whereby the lessee has failed to pay.
Okay, so relief against forfeiture. When you look at the Judicature Act, it says where the lessee. So you have to show cause that you are really willing to pay and you are still in possession. Okay. Okay. You have to show cause that you are still in possession. Then two, that you are willing to pay. In most cases, you now make a reduce the balance. Okay. So once you are granted relief against forfeiture, you can relax. No banks are warm band in the town. Nagan Kwake Natchum. When I get you with the sun in Valetta, I'll miss one quality and a turn at time. Yeah. When I get you planning Hawaii, I shall move on. Yeah. One hour I come more boom. That's all. Okay. So you get it. So now, any question on this? Yes? On the one ground. You prove that you're in possession. Possession is sufficient, so you still have interest in the same property. Members, on any question on leases, yes?
I have a question about relief against forfeiture.
Yes.
Do you make it as a Is it an application? Is it a main suit? Or must there be a suit for the lessor? Whereby the suit is a non-payment.
But for yours, okay, there is supposed to be a suit. Okay.
Can't I beg your pardon?
If not, the lessor should have applied or obtained that order, but before it is executed. Okay. Relief against forfeiture is by notes of motion, supported by an affidavit. Okay. Yes, counsel.
I'm wondering where of this the sun says to fill up the sun.
It can also fall under merger because you merge the two interests and one supersedes. Okay. Then, lastly, I want you guys to take time and read section 4 of the Land Act.
As a must.
As a must. Yes. Citizenship. Read. Read that. Because why? We are going to go through past papers next term, but you will see that number one rotates around that area. Citizenship. You want to say, but this guy is a non-citizen, the guy wants to buy Milo, you have to advise them on the available options, how best they can structure the transaction. That is always number one. Okay, so kindly take time, read section 40 and the case of Binzika versus Binzika. Understand those principles, okay? So tomorrow, we are going to look at our IA, which is brief, but we are using tomorrow to conclude the mortgages. So the last part of tenants, okay? So that means we have a class on Friday from 9 a.m. Okay. The other Friday, we shall fix a class. Okay. It is a good Friday, Council. We shall find a class we fix. Okay. On that good Friday to settle everything in land. Okay. All of those are our days, Council. Okay. 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 So, inshallah, let me look at my schedule. I want that week when we start from 9. That week after family, up to Friday, when we start at 8, up to around 3. So that in the evening, you guys relax, then you go for personal reading. Yes? Shall start at 9. But it depends which venue as well. This place is going to be occupied. The weekly days we are going to be here. Remember, your term is ending on Thursday next week. Okay? Then after Friday, Monday, you guys are starting orals. Sagara, you get it. You have 1 week.
What is the class?
Eza. Okay. Your classes are ending officially next week on Thursday. Then you have that 1 week, okay, to prepare. After that 1 week, oros. So, I want us to maximally utilize that 1 week. I will set a timetable, I will send on the platform. I say today, corporate and weekday. Over at ya and no writing. Okay? We go through all the transactions, but marathon, why? We want to get ideas on each and everything. Okay? Then we say, day one, corporate and commercial, day two, family, day two, criminal, day two, civil. Ah. We call it a term. Okay? But lastly, this is a month of Ramadan, okay? We have the simplest books in the world. We have a book called Yasaluna. It is how much? Yasaluna, okay? It's a book, okay? It's a small book for a religion, for Islamic faith, okay? It contains the alphabets, the vowels, okay? Introduction to Arabic. I am of a view, okay? How many Muslims are here? Okay? This is a month of Ramadan, a month of giving, love, forgiveness, and everything. So I'm of a view, have mosques around, okay? And you have mosques even outside the Kampala premises. So that book is 3,000, okay? Is 3,000. Okay? I'm buying it. I know. She will buy. So what am I suggesting? If we get 3,000 each, okay? With the exception of me, each. And we know deep within us what we want. Secretly, you pray deep inside you that, yeah, Allah, this is what I deserve. I'm giving this in line of belief. Based on the little I have, Allah, you understand my situation, but bless me. I need blessings. You know, for us in Islam, we believe that every letter that is ready from that book and that person doesn't forget it, it is a blessing to you who bought that book. Cancer said he's buying 10. So far we have 20. Okay? So we shall choose a mosque. Yes, 3,000 each. Okay? So we shall all approach. Cancer is buying also 5, inshallah. So we shall approach Hajat. We shall give her a contribution. Okay? And then we purchase them. Okay, we shall use Aisha. Okay, we purchase them. We shall choose a mosque before we enter Oros. Okay, and we go and we donate them, and Allah will bless us. Okay,
sure.
Even if you are belonging to the Christian faith, you can pass by your church. Okay, those guys have water bills. Don't say anything. Just pass by, go to the Yakam meter, get your phone, okay? Buy power of 10,000, load and go. You say, Lord Heavenly Father, whoever is going to use this light, let this light be mine in Oros. Okay? Every time someone will come and switch on the bulb like this, okay? You say, blessing coming to you. You get it. That's in Islam, we call it Sadaka to Jalia, okay? Blessings that never end in life. Okay? You get it? Everlasting flowing rewards. So let's work upon this. It's something small, okay? But I believe Allah has never forsaken us, okay? We are one family. I always pray for you guys because you always pray for me. Okay, so we are going to pray and we shall pray. God will answer our prayers. God has been answering our prayers every Thursday here. Okay, Allah doesn't burden a soul with more than it can. If Allah decided that you come to LDC, He knows that you can handle. So put your worries away and believe in Allah. I reasonably believe that we shall make it. Let me wish you the best of luck. May God bless you, protect you, and give you the best. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Okay.
And maybe next week on Thursday or no, Wednesday, inshallah. Okay, we have cake for concluding second term.
After Oros, and
before even we go for Oros.